Welcome to this episode of Community Talk. This week, we take a look at the President's visit to Region 9 and the major announcements geared at improving the lives of Guyanese living in that region. While addressing residents at Tapachinga Sports Ground in Letem, President Ali announced a total of 2,000 part-time jobs will be made available to persons residing across Region 9. This major undertaking forms part of the PVPC administration's plan to subsidize household income in light of the rise in cost of living.
In the coming weeks, the Vice President will be here to launch another program. That is a 2,000 jobs program. And you know what they say now, yesterday in the press conference, they say that all these people getting jobs is the PPP people. Well, apparently the whole country going PPP. It's all well and good. We one country, one Guyana. If the whole PNC ready to come PPP, one Guyana, we taking them all.
Interested persons will have to get registered, after which they will sign a one-year contract before work commences. The program caters for one person per household with a long-term intention to hire as many persons as possible. Some 600 persons who have been allocated low-income house lots in Letem, Region 9, will soon receive $1 million each to commence construction on their homes.
That is an investment on your behalf of 600 million dollars from the government. Direct transfer. We told you that you will benefit from the revenues of this country. When some said that you must not be part of it, you will benefit. You will get the benefit.
Dr. Ali underscored that the collaboration between his government and the commercial banks sees up to $1.8 billion injected into the district to push the housing drive. Residents of St. Ignatius Region 9 will benefit from major roads, bridges, and revetment works as the government accelerates infrastructural development in hinterland regions.
So let me say to you that we have already awarded two contracts. One, to complete the revetment at $130 million. And secondly, to complete the two bridges and start the road at $80 million. That is $210 million of investment to make your life better, to make your life easier.
Another $80 million has been set aside for urgent upgrades to the Mokomoko Road, bringing ease to the more than 500 residents living in that community. The community of Mokomoko is located in central Rupununi and borders St. Ignatius Village. President Ali announced that $5 million will be made available to reconstruct the village meeting place.
Over the last 6 months, we had our ministers in the region coming to all these communities to listen to you and to interact with you, to hear from you what your needs are. And then I said to them, we will respond to those needs. So for example, here in St. Ignatius, we know, right here, you want your banner back. We know that you want your banner back. So before the end of this week, the first transfer of $5 million will be made for the commencement of the revetment.
With the aim of expanding education at Shia Village, President Ali said his government will set aside some $10 million in budget 2023 for the construction of a new school. The president also committed to procuring a computer and printer for the nursery school at Shia Village.
Today I am so proud of your village. Your Tushau, 21 years old, the youngest Tushau in all of Guyana. That tells something about the people in Shia. You, the people in Shia, you believe in the future. You invest in the future. You believe in supporting young people. You invest in young people and you invest in the development.
head of state also announced that the administration will procure some 200,000 blocks that will be built by the people of Shia.
Many young people here are still in block making. In South Central, we launched a project for 300,000 blocks in the whole South Central at $35, I think, per block. I told Michelle, we are ready to work with you on launching a similar project in this community for 200,000 blocks that will be built by the people of this community. And once that is successful, we'll continue to expand that program.
The Ministry of Agriculture is also putting systems in place to deliver a number of farming tools and equipment to the community to aid with the advancement of food cultivation there. President Dr. Irfan Ali visited the village of Achiwib during a three-day outreach to Upper Takutu, Upper Essequibo Region 9. 15 million will be made available through the 2023 national budget for the extension of the water distribution system in Achiwib. Additionally, every household in Achiwib will benefit from the Hinterland Solar Program.
We know that you also want access to electricity, so we have launched a 30,000 solar program for every household in the hinterland and river community. And we're going to ensure that every household in this community benefit from that program when it starts. The Hinterland Solar Household Program, you will benefit from that also.
President Ali said his government will also set aside $2.5 million to complete infrastructural works at a recreational facility in Achiwib. He made it clear that the labor must come from within the area. The PPPC government has already injected more than $1.5 billion to increase access to safe, clean, reliable water in the hinterland and riverine communities throughout Guyana. Masa Kanari, a remote village in Deep South Rupununi Region 9, could become a major organic honey production hub. President Ali has already hinted government's intention to invest in the community, which is said to have a vast potential for apiculture practices and honey production.
I think a great opportunity for this community is also honey production. And I'm going to ask the Ministry of Agriculture to visit you to see whether they can train young people here in beekeeping and to see how we can work out maybe a system through which we can have good honey production coming from this community.
President Ali said the Agriculture Ministry will work with the community to allocate 10 acres of land to be developed into mixed farming to support the village's food production.
To support the nutritional value of the families, we know protein is very important. You have 70 households here. We want to give two pairs of Brazilian black giant that are prolific in the production of eggs to every single household. Two pairs of Brazilian black giant to every single household.
Masa Kanari is a YY community located in the deep south of the Rupununi. It is the most remote village in Guyana and has a population of just under 300 persons.